Anybody see that truck in the ditch?
Wow. Holy jackknife it pretty hard, eh? Holy man.
The B train was transporting grain to a local farm when it drifted onto the left shoulder, lost control, and slammed into the trees, snapping into a jackknife.
The rotator spent a lot of time out in Alberta. We get the two new trucks. So all of a sudden I've got too many trucks in Alberta, and I make a decision to bring the rotator back to Hope.
Yeah.
We have this truck brought back, and I think to myself, okay, well, we can do some jobs out here.
So you finally get off the desk. This is getting near the end of the season.
Yeah. It's not even there one day, and this big wreck comes in. My brother gets a call from the customer, company we've been dealing with for a long time. This is a fully loaded B train of grain.
And that's heavy, right?
Oh, it's...
Because it's dense.
It's as heavy as you can have on a load. Now, this truck's gone off the road on the left-hand side, and it's jackknifed into a tree and pretty much totaled the tractor part. Mm-hmm. And the two loaded trailers are actually sunk in the mud. We start pulling it from the back end, and we pull it out like uncoiling a snake. We're all pulling together on this thing, and I'm at the front end lifting the tractor, because what's happening is that the tractor's becoming like a big spade.
It's like an anchor.
Right, and it's digging in. So I'm lifting up on the tractor every once in a while and just kind of floating it along the top so that it doesn't dig in. Now, a lot of truckers driving by, you know, on the truck channel will comment, why do they got all those big wreckers there? What are they doing? They don't need all those trucks. You're talking about the dead weight of 62,000 kilograms. You need some serious iron to pull this unit out. You have to have weight to pull out weight. Like any wreck, it starts off great and everybody's working on it and everything's going fine. What was really a bugger in this whole job,
is it wet,
is the fact that the rain comes in and starts harder and harder, and it's like a sleet after a while coming at you sideways. Every one of us starts to get soaking wet.
My gloves are so wet, I can't even feel them.
It's worse and worse and worse.
I am soaked head to toe, man.
Yep, so am I.
This is the first time I'm on the rotator in a year. So I'm a little bit out of tune with it.
Your brother has one way to recover it, and you make a suggestion to try it a different way.
Sure.
Both of you guys are master rotator ops. You even grew up in the same world, yet you have two different approaches.
Right.
So what's going on there?
Well, it doesn't matter on any wreck. Never mind this one. At any wreck we go to, we both have different ideas on what we should be doing. And we're both bosses. We both are a bit stubborn. And that's just the way it is. Never mind this wreck. We'll go to the next wreck. It'll be the same thing. He'll be trying to tell me what to do, and I'm trying to tell him what to do, because that's what we do as bosses.
Who's older?
I'm older. I'm older.
So yeah. He should be listening to
me. He should be listening to me. Yeah, I think so. But as it turned out, we did it his way. It was really his job, so I'm following what he wants to do.
So you gotta listen to him for a
time. I gotta listen to him. It was nice to have a couple of rotators there and us working together. We hadn't worked together in probably over a year.
Mm-hmm.
And so this was kind of getting back in the saddle, enjoying just the simple life of doing a job and not the complexities of being behind a desk.
You hate the paperwork, don't you?
Hate it.
You like the engineering.
I like doing the job, yeah, way better.
How does that make you feel when you do a recovery like this? And you end up getting the thing up in one piece.
Anytime you can pull a fully loaded truck out and have it drive away again, the trailer part anyway, that's a success.